This is going to be Vision Strikers versus Attack All Around, and it has begun.
Indeed, already into B. Short Zest actually getting tapped here, quite lit up, and will be chased down now by PTC, striking first here in the Grand Finals, and it's already B site under control for the side of Attack All Around.
Well, now VS, they've got to take this site back. They've got one sitting by market side, and the rest waiting to actually make their move onto spawn. Cypher might be joining and doubling up onto Omen before breaking into site here.
You can already see Vision Strikers are going to want to play this one nice and surgically, nice and slow, looking to try and catch someone lurking over from mid, but that's not going to happen. Triple A, they just want to be able to get this first round, go for the anti-eco. Paranoia now holding back RB, as well as the number of rotations from spawn. There will now try and run the Cypher Cage on board with WannaFly, who will be traded. RB lining up for two, King as well, landing the headshot on Aesthetics. He's down to a 2v3, now only the Omen remaining, but this spike ticking away. They need to get on it now. There goes the defuse, and they will have this first round in the bag.
Yeah, they should be able to make it just in time. There we go. 0.49 VS, where AAA is going to be coming from and where they are looking to attack from might be A,
wow,
but they still have many people pushing in through this side of the map.
A blinded kill there, by the way. Conqueror completely unable to see anything, as he will now give himself a little bit of dark cover to play with, looking to push a little bit more aggressively, looking for more, but that kill onto PTC will actually secure him that Spectre.
This could be a really big lurk here coming from Cypher. He's going to be spotting out. Ooh, that's going to be Omen. Conqueror is going down. King continue to be running through the site as they rotate again, knowing that A is going to be pretty clear. Where are they going to be? Rest of AAA's members sticking close together, knowing that their own Cypher is chilling right past mid as they look to start pushing through.
I really like that push out from Vision Strikers, as you called it there, the lurk from
30
Cypher.
30 seconds left.
As that is how AAA likes to play. You can see how patiently they are now. It looks like this will go through A. Jenny will be picked up by King. Now the 3K steps in the middle of the map, kind of take their time, poke and poke here, but Vision Strikers not going to get the opportunity. As Zest now rotating around, will be picked off by Jenny. She's been a pretty standout performer here for the side of AAA, leading to many a clutch rounds here. So we've actually seen them before in this matchup. Jenny,
30 seconds left
here as Glow now trying to rotate on over. RB dropping back, dropping a few smokes as well as King. They won't finish off the enemy. PTC there, as they will now trade one for one into the site. They go AAA. They should now have control. The spike being planted by Jenny. 10 seconds to spare in the round. But the Strikers, they're going for the retake.
Oh, this is looking pretty good here. It's a 2v2, and they don't exactly have a lot of vision to be working with. Secret's going to find one. Jenny, she needs to hold on. 17 HP. This is going to be a tough situation to come out from. Drops down the Aftershock to buy a little bit more time, but Stax and Jenny, both exact same idea. Unfortunately, that fault line is going to be working out a lot. Sorry, that flashpoint is going to be working a little bit more effectively.
Yeah, indeed. Vision Strikers clutching that one. A big win.
Be timed on the site, so maybe if she had the utility, she might have made it happen, but mid-side getting completely decimated here. RB and Stax pulling back into sight. That A push is going to be thwarted as the team from AAA has been cut in half. Sova can't seem to cross over, and it's really, really scary if he does, so he has to pick up that spike and rotate towards Jenny's side.
Yeah, no, AAA, they tried to go with five-man sheriffs looking for some picks. They will manage to find only one here on their eco round, but they definitely need to get around under their belt. This is definitely a map that, if I were on panel, would be given over to AAA. This is a map that they do like to play at. I think this is their pick here, their home ground, so I'd really like to see them here try and get a decisive round, but this one will be a bit difficult for them as they're going to be ill-equipped with sheriffs versus the full buy.
I mean, it is a very slow start, of course, for AAA, especially considering the amount of rounds that VS has under their belt as of yet, but it could easily change by. Maybe on the defensive side, they might actually have a better defense than their offense, especially on a map that they are very comfortable with. Fault line comes on through, as well as the shock bolt. Doesn't none actually connecting, but at least the fault line bought enough time for the rest of the people sitting onto heaven, which is going to be Omen to pick up that kill, and now they are on the hunt.
Yeah, looking for this last kill. They need to be a bit careful, but they now have the Vision RB.
Bit more resistance. Here we go. The ultimate coming in from Breach, and the counter thunder, counter ultimate coming out as well. Both sides not looking too good here, as this is going to be a full, complete wipeout here coming in from Vision Strider. Stacks getting so many. He finally goes down. Conrad finds
two members holding here, but the operator now swinging around. We do have one here as well, but they're going to look for the member in the back of Boathouse. The flash not doing too well there. We've got a shotgun coming out there, forcing back one, but PTC with the opening kill is going to give them a man up now, as they will be looking to plant this spike here. Nice little bit of utility use. WannaFly now the kill onto the enemy. Omen is stacked now into the site. He goes. Here's the spike getting planted. That nice ka-chunk will be picked off by PTC, however.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but this isn't over just yet. But the rest of the VS, they're not going to commit to this any more than they should. They need to just back away, save their guns, save their economy, as AAA should be able to take this round. Finally, hopefully this breaks the momentum coming out of Vision Strikers.
Yeah, we did just have a pretty big buy round coming through out from Vision Strikers, but a round ago. Now, they did win, but they realize here that with 3,700 credits, it's not really going to be enough for another full double operator setup that they're going to be looking to keep here. So Vision Strikers, they're going to let this one just go. They're going to let this round take. There goes, oh, AAA, you're okay. You can take a round here. We're going to sit here with our operator with our five-round advantage, and we'll see you in the next one here. Is finally.
It's also rotated towards market side, expecting this attack to come.
I have
we don't have anyone peeking too aggressively now, but the double, the crossfire set up on two sides here. Let's see who's going to get the better trade, as AAA might be the first to go. They're going to see the cyber cage. Now, the glow, able to pick one now. Is Monofly will trade him away. They don't actually go for the crossfire. Instead, it's going to be the flash out from Stax. Might set up for another one, but that's going to be the spike carrier killed. And we should see Vision Strikers now rotate appropriately. The PTC, in the meantime, gets the kill onto RB. Nice one. That's the operator taken care of, as he will be lurking around trying to flank them. That's going to pull members from Vision Strikers away to try and deal with this one, as we see now up in heaven holding against the
left.
Jet. Just needs to be careful there. Cypher might actually get the peek here. They now have scouted each other, maybe through the floor. A little bit of a flash now, but Stax through the smoke, finding one. They're going to be able to smoke that one off yet again as Ascetics trading to the breach.
Yeah, but that's unfortunate because they were carrying Spike. This Spike should have been dropped so much earlier. They're starting to run out of time here. Soba's got to make
left.
A decision, get Ron, but now that Shock Arrow once again going to be stopping this. Oh, that's not going to be enough time to get that bomb down,
spike
unfortunately.
Planted.
Oh, no. Whoa. They actually got it. Wow, he actually committed through the Shock Arrow as well.
Yeah, the doors close and Zest there land in the operator shot onto PTC. Ascetics holding onto one, but that allows Zest there to peek, kill off his double, and secure the sixth round for the Korean squad. Vision Strikers up 6-1.
Mm-hmm. Must have been so much chaos because I didn't even hear him actually start it up before the B-site here. This could be really, really brutal for them if they all get spotted out. I mean, the Owl Drone is starting to come out. The Recon Dart has revealed four, and now the Rolling Thunder
the collateral.
As well.
The collateral there, Zest finding PTC and Ginny, two prominent members here on the side of attack all around. Now we'll find a third before Congrid kills the enemy Omen. Stax is not going to allow them to get the ace, but WannaFly, the left only remaining member. Operator shot actually whiffs there, but it's not going to be too successful for the rest of the round here for attack all around. Definitely, they now have now gained control of their favorite section of map. Now heading into mid-market, they have another member holding there. They actually saw where that dark cover came from, but glow a little bit too fast there. Sheriff shot not connecting, his RB connected. That operator now onto the ETC and gets a second one with the tailwind to ensure he's able to escape.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they're going to continue to try and get as much damage in here.
10 seconds
but
left.
At this point, just getting one casualty would be good enough. Just killing the copper maybe. Oh, but RB just taking out.
Play here, and guess what? We're going to be ready for that information as, again, it's going to be through mid-market. A short little flash, good position. Low, so he's not going to be able to get any trade now. Door being blown open, but Stackshot getting the kill rather onto the spike carry. A bit of madness as Ascetics will be able to sneak up onto Zest. And now that should be B-side under control. Oh, no, they just needed to spray a bit longer through the smoke as WannaFly will be able to trade off Stacks. Spike still under control as nice double peek. WannaFly with an even better shot, though, is going to put them up 2-1 here. It's going to be up to Ascetics as well as PTC to see if they can actually clutch this round and get their second round win here, Gideon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this could be it. I mean, it's a 1v2 situation, and don't forget that Jet also still has her ult, and yep, here we come, the Bladestorm might be what it takes to 2v1 this situation. Does she want to actually pull this off? We're just going to have to wait. PTC as well as Ascetics trying to make the best out of the situation, and unfortunately...
As we see Zest swinging around wide with the operator, actually just... Did I see that? That's a two! Oh, it doesn't get the collateral, but we'll get Ascetics now. Good stuff. I'm not even... Oh my goodness, he shot him in the arm here now. That's going to be a pretty big gaping wound there. As now the Rolling Thunder on through the site as Zest finding the kill onto Conga Red. Zest looking for more here as he has now successfully repelled his push. Stax pushing around through all the way as PTC from mid-connector. But what a flick out from Zest. He's not even reloaded once. He's got three kills. Will not get a fourth as Jenny will be able to find the perfect peek onto him.
She needs to make something happen here. It's a 1v3 situation. If this is Ginny's time to shine, this would be a phenomenal moment for her.
Oh, it's not going to be easy, though. Glow holding back of Hunt as King. Able to of the Sovas. A very traditional one, just a few sidesteps. The Snacks now sidestepping over into the peak. We'll find the kill onto Ascetics. That's a big kill there. Ascetics generally a big performer and sometimes even a top fragger for the side of AAA.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and here it comes, that Rolling Thunder once again as they start pushing through mid side here. Ooh, exactly. Great utilization of that element, but WannaFly is going to be able to get that ult, that Cypher ult down, revealing the positions of all the defenders as they look to lock themselves in PTC, finding one more. It's headshot for headshot as they push through B site once again. Boathouse needs to be cleared, but it's only going to be one guy. The rest of the team from VS making their way towards B.
Yeah, Stack's shoulder peeking now. He's going to get, one. Might be finding another one. He will before PTC puts him down, but that's a 2-for-1 trade. We have the rest of the members from Vision Strikers now approaching the site. PTC with the airstrike with a weapon out, though, will be picked off by King and Ida of Vision Strikers. They've just had no problems full buying out from round three. It was pretty much full equipment. So AAA, they've been put in a bit of a pinch here. They've only got two rounds to lose before they have to play for it. The draw is now kicking it off. Will be Zest for the side of Vision Strikers. RB rotating through the mid lane here, however, is going to find a 1-for-1 trade, making it 4-3 early on.
Mm-hmm. Very nicely done here, especially since they are going a little bit more aggressive to catch VS off guard. Glow, he finds the Lurker pushing out of B site. That's looking real, real nice for VS as they look to try and end this as soon as possible and force AAA into an econ round.
Yeah, this is kind of incredible. It kind of seems like they've got the playbook here. Vision Strikers, they know the playbook. They're in the huddles even of AAA as they've just been outplaying them with these small aggressive moves.
It's frustrating to see because Vision Strikers, like, they didn't have too many games overall and they were performing just so well against teams that they haven't seen before sometimes. And that just kind of shows the caliber of team that everybody is trying to beat right now, especially AAA.
Indeed, it's the grand final everyone expected here as Vision Strikers with the spike plant are going to get the jump onto one before actually WannaFly is going to be able to land the majority of his shots first. That's a nice start here. Is the bomb ticking away? It's actually over, it sounds like, in B. Mm-hmm. We do have King now watching over with the classic Ginny, 8 HP. Not really full HP either so far on our Cypher as they will be rotating on through, dodging out that fault line. WannaFly up to heaven they go, but King finds the pick onto one that must have been through the wall. Unbelievable there. Spike continuing to tick away a bit faster. They want to be able to get the fuse, but we will get a little bit more damage done at the very least.
Flying from Lurkers.
Yeah, and look at B main. Yep, that's going to be working out. Jenny being picked off, and that's B completely wide and open for the taking. A bit of aggressive play out from Ascetics. He's unable to find a single kill. Just, in fact, doesn't even really get too much damage there. Maybe Cypher being tapped once, but Zest now is going to get a kill with the Bulldog on the Conqueror at PTC. And WannaFly, they're both left with shorties and a dream.
They drop down the spike. It's going to be a 2v5 here, and it's... Oh boy, how do you even clear this out? You've got a shorty and a dream, but two shots and you're already on the reload.
Yeah, pretty much as well, they're going to be maybe hoping that someone lurks on through as, I can't believe this. This might be horrible. Oh, no, but RB just too fast there on the reaction time, getting the kill onto the Evil Jet. This could be a flawless anti-eco round here, but AAA, the Cypher just running all the way over, playing with his camera in the corner in wine, and just hoping that he can just manage to escape this round only with a shorty.
Mm-hmm. And that just shows VS have set themselves up for victory in this game one itself. This is going to put AAA in a very precarious position because VS, they could just upgrade their guns without any worry about, Spectres don't need them anyways.
Point.
Yeah, they'll have the equipment advantage, but 4v5 without the operator, it's going to be tough, but I like this play out from AAA. They do need to do something a little bit, you know, high risk, high reward to try and get back into this game and just seize economy control. But Vision Strikers, they're going to be probably scouting this one out, not upgrading, saving plenty of money in case the worst happens.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, with this recon hour, they know for a fact, okay, so Sova is sitting on B. That's a little bit of information. The question is, where is everybody else going to be as he whips out? Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
wait.
That's an Odin. Yeah, we do see this one be quite the favorites of defenders here on this site, and this could be actually kind of disastrous for Vision Strikers. They're going to be holding a tight angle flash, but just holding down that trigger before dropping back now. Paranoia just can't see a single thing, doesn't even see or maybe even hear the jet now, who will be able to close the gap instantly. Has Vision Strikers, well, they're looking to be able to close the match.
Mm-hmm. Yep, with this many people, it's 5v4. Let's see how AAA is going to handle this. They've got two coming in through market and two coming through spot. spawn. Somebody needs to make the first move. They've got all their utility ready to make this push. The Paranoia comes through. Cypher is going to get tagged out, but on the opposite side, Sova is going to be launching that recon arrow, and that's going to slow the push even more.
Nice pick. Even with the Spectres, Vision Strikers playing this so defensively, and they're still getting the better of the trade. Just Zest with the Bulldog now makes it a 4-5-1. Ginny, the only one left alive, as they're looking bigger off, and they're just not going to be able to get it done here. Attack all around. They fall 13-2.